How to change iTunes backup location on Windows PC. By default, iTunes stores backup file on our system drive and see the result. Unfortunately, there is no way to change backup location from iTunes itself. To address this problem, we have to create a symbolic link, and only in this way we can change iTunes backup location. In this video, I'll show you how we can create a symbolic link with hard junction to change iTunes backup location. First of all, we need to make sure hidden folders are visible on our PC. Therefore, we'll go to folder options. Then view. Then here we need to select show hidden folders option. Now we'll go to iTunes backup folder location. We need to go to our system drive. Then user. Then we need to open our user account folder. In my case, my user account name is Rafi. Therefore, I'll open Rafi. Then AppData. Then roaming. Apple computer. MobileSync. And here is the culprit iTunes backup folder. Let's check what is the size of the folder. Wow, it's 18 GB. That's why my system drive was almost full. Well, you can either delete the folder, or if you want, you can keep old backup. You can copy the backup file to another drive. I'll copy my backup folder. Let's say I'll copy it to G drive. After copying backup, we need to delete the system drive's backup folder. Now we'll create a symbolic link to the backup folder we copied in G drive. It means we are simply telling to Windows whatever data iTunes try to store in system drive's backup folder, you just divert it to G drive's backup folder. To divert backup file, we'll open CMD here. To open CMD within current folder, we need to right click while holding shift key from keyboard. Then click on open command prompt here. Now CMD is opened. Now we need to write exact same command I'm writing here. mklink /. J means hard link, then double quotes followed by percentage app data, again percentage, / Apple / computer, / mobile sync, / backup followed by double quotes. Now we'll give destination link within double quotes. Opening double quotes, G colon / backup. Closing double quotes, and now we'll press enter, and we can see Windows created a backup shortcut. This backup shortcut will send the iTunes backup file to our backup folder in G drive. Okay, we are almost done. Now we'll check whether Windows is storing iTunes backup files in new G drive backup folder or not. I connected my iPhone to my PC. Now I'll start taking backup. Let iTunes take a bit backup. Okay, enough to see the situation. Let's open G drive. Backup folder. Now we see Windows is storing iTunes backup file to this new backup folder. Remember, my iPhone backup file was little more than 18 GB, and this one is less than 1 GB. Remember, iTunes usually overwrite backup files. Hence, if you want to keep old backup files, you always need to move the old backup files from backup folder. In my case, I just overwrote my backup file. I hope you understood how to change iTunes backup location. If still you face any problem, you are welcome to tell me via comment section. I'll try my best to help you with my limited knowledge. Thanks for watching my video. Take care. Peace.